Russia is a big country, both population and land-wise. It must be no surprise then that they're one of the main world powers and have been basically ever since that term has existed. But it hasn't really always been that way. For the longest time, Russia was just a really big Eastern European backward tsardom, where, contrary to Western Europe, the nobility still grew their beards. But the country still had so much land and people. Why didn't they modernize? Well, it did eventually under Tsar Peter the Great. He implemented massive modernization reforms influenced by Western Europe. He reorganized the army, created dress codes for nobility based primarily on those of France, and most importantly, tried to make Russia a naval power. But how are you supposed to make a country with only one seaport in Arkhangelsk a naval power? If you don't know, Arkhangelsk is located here, and for months every winter the port was closed because of sea ice. And it wasn't just a dumb mistake to build a seaport here. The Arctic really was just the only sea the Russians had a coast on. The current Russian coast in the Far East wasn't conquered yet. Sweden still controlled the entire Gulf of Finland, and the current Russian Black Sea coast was controlled by the Ottoman Empire. Mostly because of this lack of warm water and a Baltic presence, Russia went to war with Sweden in 1700. And along with Denmark and Prussia, they won this war against an alliance of Sweden, the Ottoman Empire, Great Britain, the Dutch Republic, and the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth. The war is actually seen as the start of the decline of Sweden and the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth as European powers. But I digress. After this war, Russia had gained a lot of Baltic coastline, and this included the cities of Tallinn and Riga, which added some really nice coastal cities to Russia. But Peter the Great wasn't satisfied yet. He wanted to build a massive new city that had to function as a capital, seaport, and center of modern culture and architecture. St. Petersburg. The perfect spot was the mouth of the Neva River near the Swedish fortress Nyanskans. The city would start around the fortress Peter had built 5 kilometers inland during the war after destroying the previous Swedish fortress. The city was built under the supervision of Alexander Menshikov and by conscripted peasants from all over Russia. These peasants were actually more like slaves since they worked under the most terrible conditions. Tens of thousands died building the city. First, the plan was to build a city around Trinity Square, on the right bank of the river next to the fortress Peter had established earlier. But later, architect Dominika Trezzini had suggested a project whereby the city center would be located on Vasilievsky Island, which is the big island over here. The city center would have been shaped by a rectangular grid of canals, and although this plan was never fully completed, you can still see its remnants in the street layout on the island today. In 1716, finally, Peter appointed Jean-Baptiste Alexandre Leblanc as the chief architect of the new city. According to the plans of these three people, most of the modern-day hotspots in St. Petersburg were built, such as the Winter Palace and other Byzantine-influenced Russian architecture. After the capital was moved to St. Petersburg as early as 1712, a good naval presence was established, and Peter the Great personally established the Academy of Sciences, University, and Academic Gymnasium. The city quickly grew to be one of the most influential and important ones in Europe, and it still sort of is. And although much of the Russian nobility at the time hated Peter the Great for his modernization reforms, he is now remembered as the person who helped Russia out of its backwards existence and made it one of the most important military and cultural players in Europe and later the world. And the biggest symbol of all of this might as well be the city of St. Petersburg itself.